If you live in the National Capital Region, you will have heard of people killing for a parking space. I'm not joking. Murders for parking spaces. It's an unbelievable reality, borne out by the fact that there are simply too many cars and no space to park, and that there is absolutely no sense of the need for more parking space. Projecting growth in the future in terms of infrastructure, by which I mean parking spaces, evidently never struck anyone. But now the Supreme Court has had enough, and they've outlined the importance of several guidelines which they believe are necessary. But realistically, who is going to implement this? And where does the money come from? That's our big focus this evening. Sunita Narayan, the director of the Center for Science and Environment, with us. We're also joined by Chetan Singh, the political analyst, Bhaskar Ghosh of the BJP, and Arvind Singh, the national coordinator for the National Association of Street Vendors of India. Sunita, let me come to you first. The suggestions made by the Supreme Court, Sunita, are absolutely phenomenal. Drop-and-go zones, a separate lane for unhindered movement of traffic, proper parking facilities in residential areas. One could go on and on. Simple question, who pays for this?
Well, Vishnu, that's exactly why the court was asked to intervene. There's a history to this. There are parking rules that have been made for Delhi, a policy and then rules. And for the last 6 months, we have been asking the Delhi government to notify those rules. Those rules include in them all these provisions and the, you know, the further suggestions that the court has asked for. But you need a legal framework before you can actually regulate parking. The question of pricing is in fact been the billion-dollar question. The fact is that the parking rules provided that they will be charging for parking both in commercial areas as well as in residential areas, and that municipalities will use those charges both to create new facilities for parking as well as to better manage parking and share the revenue with the residential welfare associations. Mm-hmm. The AAP government has opposed that, and those provisions for pricing of parking were dropped by the government. EPCA took this matter to Supreme Court because we feel very strongly that you will have to charge for parking. However, the court in its wisdom has said that matter of pricing will be decided later. Let's first implement these three pilot projects, and then we will come back to the issue of pricing. But I very firmly believe, Vishnu, that unless we talk about the pricing of parking, it's a subsidy to the rich for parking on public land. It is something that we have to address. But I understand the court, and I understand, and we will take this matter up further.
Yep.
Because we have to win this battle.
No, I understand the point that you're talking about. Real estate is valued. There is a price attached to real estate. And the sense mm-hmm. that you can just park anywhere and that becomes essentially a space, or your personal Absolutely. Space is something which needs to change. That's not the case anywhere in the world, and perhaps for good reason. Arvind Singh, your thoughts on this. Do you believe that we need to give serious impetus to clearing up our roads, but doing that in a place as chaotic as Delhi means transforming the lives of citizens? It's not going to be easy to do that. Where is the physical space to create, for example, parking?
No, see, first of all, we believe that there is enough space. There has to be mindset, there has to be heart to make cities inclusive, you know. And also, you know, there are a lot of issues related to municipal governance. Whether we have created capable municipal corporations to implement that, that's a big, big question. Who will bail the cat? You know, we all know that, you know, that, and citizens are, there are also, for example, I work with street vendors. They are willing to, more than willing to pay to the municipal corporation for putting up the stalls. We have been shouting for regulation. There is also a street vending act. But the problem is, We know very well what happened to the Swachh Bharat mission in Delhi itself, you know, because we couldn't implement that. Delhi remains a dirty capital, you know, merely because who will bail the cat? Who will address the issue of local municipal governor? Who will actually do it on the ground? How much will the courts be able to force that? We want a livable city. We want a nice city. Everybody wants to walk, you know. People also like to buy from vendors. If vendors are in proper presentation, their income will also increase, you know. But we cannot allow cities to be free for all, you know, that anybody, anywhere, anything, you know, that is also impossible. So it is urgent upon us on all the segments, you know, to...
Okay. Mr. Ghosh, you know, again, the basic issue of pricing, this becomes very sensitive from an election standpoint as well. I should mention the Aam Aadmi Party chose not to be part of this particular program. But irrespective of the government in power in Delhi, in the National Capital Region, it becomes very difficult. Which political party would have the strength to actually enforce very high pricing in many cases to deter people from parking wherever they want?
See, I like to show it from a different angle. The vehicle population of Delhi is about 109.86 lakhs. And there was a move by the respective municipal corporations that the parking which has been outside the house should be charged. And they have proposed that it should be the civic agency along with the RWA should fix up the charge. Now, the transport minister of Aam Aadmi Party, Kailash Gehlot, on February 1 has called off that particular resolutions and particular order. And now this becomes a vote bank politics for the Aam Aadmi parties.
But isn't it going to be vote bank politics for you as well?
No, I see. We have initiated.
Are you happy with the moves? Are you willing to endorse it?
We are willing. That's why I'm telling you. Today, there are also some changes in the usage of the entire Delhi's private areas. Like you see the market of Karol Bagh, the market of Lajpat Nagar. They are not supposed to be the markets. They are supposed to be the private colonies and localities. Now they are transformed into market. So therefore, additional pressures are there. And those vehicles are basically commercially used vehicle. They come for the shopping or they are the owner, shop owners used to keep it. So immediately there should be charge should be fixed. And the RWA and civic agency should be immediately instructed to recover the charges. And that is what Supreme Court is insisting on.
Okay.
Right?
I just want to go across to Chetan Singh, who joins us as well. Okay, we don't have Chetan. In fact, I can go back to Sunita. Sunita, in all of the measures which have been suggested so far, what do you believe is the one that can actually bring about the maximum amount of change in decongesting our roads? It's one thing to say that if people pay, then they will not park everywhere. But then where do these cars go? What kind of parking will the city see?
So Vishnu, in fact, there's a lot of work that has happened on this, and I think we need to be clear that this is not a magic wand that you can have, but what EPCA did was to give to the court a very detailed report which the South Delhi Municipal Corporation has actually worked on in Lajpat Nagar 3 and Lajpat Nagar to come up with what is a parking management plan, both for residential areas as well as for commercial areas. The point we have made to the court is that you cannot not regulate parking in residential areas, which is what the Aam Aadmi government was trying to do, because otherwise there will be a spillover from residential to commercial. But if you take the plan, what you have to do colony by colony, which is what the court has now directed, is that you will have to determine how many cars there are. You will have to determine what will be legal parking, what is the spillover area. For instance, in Lajpat Nagar, it was found that there are double the number of cars than there are spaces. Mm-hmm. So what do? You then find in Lajpat Nagar, the STMC found that there are a lot of spaces where there is nighttime parking that is available. So there are spaces where you can provide for parking for residential areas in nighttime, market areas where you don't need parking at night.
Sure.
Shared parking is possible. You will also have to build multi-level parking, But for all that, clearly what you need is a plan, you need pricing, and you need deterrence. So you need all three together. And what the court has asked us right now is, they've given us the plan, a legal plan. They have said very clearly, implement it in three pilot areas. And I'm still hoping that with this implementation, we can go back to the court and show them that it is imperative that we have both the pricing as well as the deterrence for this to be rolled out across the city.
Yeah.
But I think it is very important today, Vishnu, because without the restraint on cars, we will never be able to get better better pollution management as well. And that's where the use of public transport becomes critical. If you restrain the growth of cars, you build an interface with public transport.
Back to you in a moment. Let me just go across to Mr. Chetan Singh, who joins us as well. Mr. Singh, the points that have been mentioned by Sunita, the points which the court has actually spoken about, do you believe that this can be implementable in a finite period of time? That it's all very well to look at specific areas as trial areas, but to replicate these trial areas to other colonies, how difficult is that going to be?
See, first, when it comes down to the intent of the government is something which is most important. If there is an intent, and I'm sure, you know, intent can always be always.
Sorry, we've lost that signal with him over there. You had a point to make, Mr. Ghosh? Yeah.
See, one more interesting point. The 95.5% of these cars are standing.
Yeah.
They're in standing position. They're
yeah.
not being utilized. So there is one family and maybe 10 cars, maybe
yeah.
6 cars. So again, if you see about Singapore, there's first car is usual price, but the moment you're going to buy the next car, it is more expensive, it is an auction.
Yeah.
So in apart from this, allocating their space and charges, this kind of rule also could be considered, that whether a family of 4 should be using 8 cars.
The question is,
then that
is also linked to the scrappage policy, that people need to be encouraged
yeah.
to actually give up their cars.
So,
and
yeah,
that's
exactly.
something which the government
so
needs to look
part,
at
that's
very
there's
closely.
Two part. One is accommodating
yeah.
the cars.
Sunita, you had a point
is, yeah.
to make. Go ahead before I go back to Chetan very briefly. Yeah, Sunita, go
yeah,
ahead.
Vishnu, just to make the point that as part of the parking policy, in fact, one of the things is that, and we have found this happening in many residential areas of Delhi already, that RWAs are actually charging differential rates for additional cars. And I think that's the principle. You can't really ask people to give up the cars.
Right.
But if you limit the space, you say that there is only space for one car parking or two car parking, you start limiting it, and then you charge more, or you ask people to park the third car in a multi-level parking area or a shared parking, you're creating a different kind of a parking arrangement. So this is something that is very important.
All right, I take your point. Last comments to you, Chetan. You were losing your line. Go ahead. I was asking you about whether you see this being actually implementable in across large parts of the city beyond the areas where these trials are going on.
Vishnu, you know, the intent plays a very vital role. If you remember, you know, when this government rule came up that even a pedestrian rider must need to wear a helmet, you see that how it got implemented. It just got implemented overnight. Same thing has happened in Mumbai also when it came down to the two-wheelers wearing a helmet. So here, what I'd like to say is, here is the intent of the government. Is the intent is pure. If they really want to get it done, it's going to happen. Second most important, it's a very sensitive issue. Even the people, you know, I mean, who live in societies, communities, cities, they also understand now. They are also very much aware about it, that vehicular pollution is taking a next level, first. Second most important, because of the parking fights, because of these, you know, small little conflict which comes up because of the parking slot. You see, like, number of lives are getting lost is also substantial, which is increasing. You look at what I'm trying to say here is that it is important for schools, especially the school level education, need to be get addressed. Because again, what I said, sensitive. It's a sensitive issue. Sensitive issue means like even the small kids would be taught about
yeah.
it, that, you know, see.
I think, Chetan, it's an issue which affects the quality of lives of millions of people, the fact that we've had this dramatic growth in the number of cars, not just in Delhi, but across our country within a period of just 10 years or so, means that we are utterly unprepared for this. And we are having this discussion today when, in fact, these solutions should have been provided 15 years ago. I'd like to thank all of you very much for joining us and sharing those thoughts, and Sunita for keeping up this battle to make so many people like all of us included, change our way of living to actually care about fellow citizens and care about the city that we live in. Thanks very much indeed.